Alright, in this video, we're going to go through the vocabulary for the scripture, Exodus 34, chapter 34, verses 1 through 10. And I'm going to go through the vocabulary here, and I'm going to assume that if you've chosen to do the scripture, that you've already done some signing, you've kind of got basics down, the songs are a little bit easy for you, and you want to have something a little bit of a challenge. But I'm going to treat you like you know a little bit of signs, okay? And so I'm going to go kind of quickly through this. But before I get started, I just want to say something about these scriptures. This scripture is probably the central, most important scripture in the Old Testament. It was by these verses that the people knew and understood the personality, the person of God. I don't normally preach at the beginning of one of these things, but I really think this one's particularly important. We have this misconception, I think, sometimes that Old Testament God is mean, cruel, harsh, judgmental, legalistic. And somehow in the New Testament, he got a new personality, one that's grace and forgiveness and patience. And what we need to understand is God didn't change his personality. God has been that way the whole time. And this set of verses, when God introduces himself to Moses and thus to his people and to us, he uses words like, I am kind, I am merciful, slow to anger, full of great love. This doesn't describe a God of harshness. Okay? So, this particular translation I don't like. I'll tell you that up front. I think the translators on this one missed the point entirely. Because God at one point in this says, he forgives to the thousands of generations. And then in the next verse it says that, oh, but he's not going to forget to punish the people. He's going to punish them, and their children, and their grandchildren. That's not what Scripture is trying to say. The Scripture is trying to do a comparison to show something, how big and how small. God forgives thousands of generations, and he punishes the three or four. Okay? It's the comparison, not the numbers. And it's not that he's going to, if you mess up, he's going to punish you, your kids, and your grandkids. That's not what he's talking about. He's talking about the disparity between how much he forgives and how much he hates to actually punish. Okay? So anyway, when I get to those things, we're going to interpret it the same way that what it is on the paper here. And I chose this particular one because it's easiest to sign, but it's not the best translation. I encourage you to read this in other translations. Anyway, preaching aside, here is the vocabulary for Exodus. Okay? Introduce yourself, and then you say Exodus, and you're going to spell it out. Okay. For some reason, my mind is not focusing. Alright. Exodus. Alright. Chapter. Chapter. It's like you're going to choke somebody. That kind of hand. Chapter is going down. Verses are smaller. Smaller. And they go across the page. So chapter 34, that's 3-4, verses 1 through 10, okay? 1 through 10. I'm assuming you know your numbers. Here we go. Then the Lord said to Moses, then you touch the thumb, then you touch the finger, then, kind of make a little loop there. The Lord, L, coming from the shoulder opposite your elbow, coming down to your hip, said to Moses, okay, this is told Moses, said to Moses. Moses is a famous guy. He's got his own sign. It looked like that. Okay? Kind of like wide-eyed, coming off the side. I'm not sure how to describe that sign. But anyway, that's Moses. Make two stone tablets like the first two that were broken. And if you've been doing this with me at all, you know how I harp on doing things in phrases. We're going to do this in phrases. I'm going to show you the individual signs, but you need to do this in phrases to remember it, to be able to express the ideas behind it. So, make. It's like having a pencil that you're holding on to, and you're going to twist it in half. Okay? Not, you know, you don't have to have the veins poking out in your arms to do that. It's a calm sign. Breaking it may be overstating it. Anyway, make two, that's easy. More, it's like taking all your fingers together and having them kiss. More, stone. A stone is like, this is the stone, and you knock on it, and it's hard. Okay, stone. Tablets. And I wrestled a little bit with how to sign this one. There is no signs for tablets. And if you haven't, and you probably, if you haven't, you ought to see the old Charlton Heston movie with the Ten Commandments. There's a picture of, he had them, they look like little tombstones. I don't think they look like tombstones. I think they just look like square pieces of rock, okay? And so I'm going to sign it like tablets. And that's the way I'm going to sign it. It's not really a sign. It's really more of a pantomime. But it does communicate. And that's how the deaf would communicate that. Tablets. Like the first two. Okay? Like is a white hand kind of shaking back and forth. The same here as it is there. So like the first, kind of thump your thumb. Two that were broken. Two that were broken. Two, easy. That were. In sign language, you divide your head in half. Time type signs that go this direction are past. Time type signs that go this way are future. So this is past. That were. It's not even, that's not even really, there's no English equivalent to that sign. It just means pastedness. Something happened in the past. That were broken. Again, that poor pencil, we're just going to break it in half this way, because it's twisted in half. I will write the same words on these stones that were written on the first two stones. I, now what am I doing here? This is time for I, or I, but I'll do I this way. I, but it's not really me, I'm speaking for God. I am quoting God. So I'll point up. I would do the same thing if, say, you were in the room here and I was quoting you and I said, I like popcorn. You know, everybody would know that I was saying it as if I were you. Okay. I will write, take your imaginary pencil, take out your imaginary notebook, and imaginarily write something on there. The same words, okay, we already did same before, words, make a little sign and put it there, kind of like a flag, I'm not sure why that's words, but anyway, that's words. On these stones, on, you gotta lay your hand on top of the other, these stones, okay, these, take your fingernail, on your pointer finger there, just run it across the other finger. Okay, these stones that were, same sign as before, written on the first two stones. Alright, we got half of those signs done in the first couple sentences there. Next, be ready tomorrow morning and come up on Mount Sinai. B. It's the letter B coming out off the chin. Make sure it's moving. Alright? Because if it's not moving, it has different meanings. You become towards yourself with a B, building a place. The mountain is going to be here, and that's where Moses and God are going to be. And there's going to be an area down here where all the people are. And so instead of being exact, where I'm using the exact words, you know, the exact words would be, and come up on Mount Sinai, right? That's not right. That doesn't communicate well. I'm going to build a mountain here, and I'm going to say, go up Mount Sinai. All right? And I'll be able to use that mountain later. So it's important. And mountain is nothing more than a rock, stones, that go uphill. Stand before me there on the top of the mountain. Okay, here I can see my mountain. Okay? Stand, right? To just build a plateau and stand. And I kind of got it over here because that's where I'm going to go with this. Before me, same as I did five before, there. Why am I pointing there? Because I built a mountain there. There. On the top of the mountain. Okay? I'm just going to build a mountain here. I'm going to put a crest on it, and there's the top of the mountain. Okay? No one will be allowed to come with you. No one. This is a sign for no, as in none. Yes, I have none bananas. I guess I have no bananas. This would be no, as in no, you can't have a banana. And this would be, I know I can't have a banana. Okay? So, no, as in no. No, as in none. This is none people. Zero people. Okay? Will be, will is just kind of a hand flying past your ear. You probably use this as part of your introduction, like I will be interpreting or something. Okay? Will. No one, let's see, where am I? What's my place? No one will be allowed. Just kind of L hands, point down, not straight down, but point down like a 45 degree angle and just bring them up to a 45 degree angle. Alright? Will be allowed to come up with you. Now, when Moses went up, we had come up. So, no one will be allowed to come up with you. Alright? See what I did there? I used the same signs as I did for Moses as I did for the people going up with him. It communicates them better that way. Okay? No one should even be seen anywhere on the mountain. Even. It's not flat. It's not even as opposed to odd. It's just an emphasis word. And so we're going to leave out the word even. All these emphasis words, we can just, most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time, we can leave them out and just put the emphasis in the sign. So, real simple example, going back to our no. I mean, no, no, no. You know, I've signed the same thing three times, but I put the emphasis differently. We can put emphasis into our sign. So, no one should even be seen anywhere on the mountain. No one should be seen anywhere on the mountain. No one should be seen, I'm pointing to the mountain with this hand, and I'm seeing with this hand. In sign language, our eyeballs are on the ends of our fingers, so it's really convenient. You can see with them. And our emphasis for, like, even should no one should even be seen, is seen in how we actually sign that sign. Anywhere. Any is an A hand, a circling snaking down. Okay. Anywhere hands kind of cross them and go, where? It's kind of like your mom coming into your room and you say, I cleaned up my room, and they go, and she goes, where? You can see that sign. I know you can see that sign. Okay, anywhere on the mountain. On the mountain. Even your herds, okay, again, even if you're thinking of the emphasis, so even your herd, you know, this is going to make an area here of animals and flocks of sheep, okay, herds of animals, flocks of sheep. This sign for animals, this sign for sheep. And the way I remember sheep is the story of Jacob and Esau, where Jacob, to try to pretend to be his brother, who was so hairy, he wrapped sheepskin around his arm and put it in front of his blind dad and said, feel that, Dad. I'm Esau. That's where I remember the sign. Anyway, you can remember it however which way you want to. Will not, okay, and not is a thumb coming from like your Adam's apple to your chin, okay? Not be allowed, we've already seen all those signs, to eat grass, eat, you know, just kind of putting food in your mouth, eat grass. Grass is kind of an odd sign. It's kind of your palm here, almost touching your chin, eat grass. At, okay, just here's a place, and you're going to be right there, at this spot, okay, at the bottom of the mountain, okay, now I didn't sign bottom, did I? I have built the mountain, and I've got the area down here, so I'm going to refer to this area as the bottom of the mountain. Okay? Alright, so Moses made two more stone tablets. So Moses, so we can leave it out or we can sign it truly. In this case, I'm just going to leave it out. So Moses made two more, we know all those signs, stone, know that, tablets, light, we already know that, first one, we know all those signs. Early. This is kind of like the runner in track who's sitting there. He's ready to go. And he's waiting for the gun to go, and oh, he gets off just before the gun goes off. He gets off early. Okay. The next morning, or just early in the morning, you can leave out next if you want to, but if you want to put it in there, that's the sign for next. Morning. This is the sun coming up. We've had that. Moses went up Mount Sinai just as the Lord commanded him to. Okay? Just the same, or just the same, you can put the just, do the just in there or not, but just as, or the same as, the Lord commanded, it says the Lord commanded, okay? Moses carried the two stone tablets with him. Okay, now Moses carried, I'm going to do carried this way. Carried this way. Carried. Anyway, I still have that picture in my mind of Charlton Heston in the Ten Commandments. He's got both of those tombstones held this way in his arm. Okay? And we might just carry on that picture. If you haven't seen the movie, you really ought to. It's a pretty good movie. Probably, I know it's made with, when most of you guys are born. Anyway, Moses carried the two stone tablets with him. Stone tablets with him. Okay? With two A-hands coming together. And the two A-hands could be in one place, and with me. But if I'm going someplace, it can go with me. It can travel. Alright? So he took the two stone tablets with him. Then the Lord came down in a cloud. Okay, now why am I doing it up here? Okay, I could do it over here. I could say it came down in a cloud. But I'm doing it up here. Why? Because that's where Moses is. He went up on the mountain. All right? So the Lord came down to him in a cloud and stood there with Moses and spoke his own name. Okay? I'm pretty sure I didn't miss something. Oh, I think I did. All right. So sometimes I've got the verse up here in front of me, and sometimes it's easy to miss when I'm not paying attention all the time. So the Lord came down in a cloud. Now clouds are just kind of fluffy things in the sky, but we know, because we've read the Bible, that the cloud that God comes down into is a pillar, and it's a pillar by day, a cloud by day, a pillar of fire by night. So I'm going to make the cloud just instead of fluffy this way, fluffy this way, came down, okay? And the Lord came down on him in a cloud and stood there with Moses, okay? Stood, to stand with Moses, there with Moses, and spoke his own name. So God here is going to speak his own name. He's going to speak his own name. Side project, side comment here. When Moses asked God what was his name, what did he reply? I know you know this. I am. Okay, now the way that the translators did here, they said Yahweh. Y-A-H-W-E-H. You're going to need to practice finger spelling that, by the way. That's not a word you have probably ever written down in front of you. So practice finger spelling that, because we're going to use it here in a minute. But Yahweh, if you look at the actual Hebrew letters, it looks like the same letters that are used in I am. So Moses is more than likely hearing God say, I am. Okay? Sorry, I'm starting to lose my voice here a little bit. Okay. So the Lord passed in front of Moses. Passed. This is you standing still, so I'm going to go around you. Keep going. Okay? Passed in front of Moses. In front of. This is where his face is. Right? Right in front of his face. In front of Moses. And said, Yahweh, the Lord, is kind. Alright? And again, the translators here, I don't think got it right. The Lord is saying, I am the Lord. I am kind. But we're going to sign it the way the translator did here. Kind. And, okay, kind. Two K hands, kind of top of each other, making a little bit of a circle. Kind. And merciful. Think about this. This is God introducing himself. He is kind and merciful. This is in Exodus, way back to the beginning of the Bible. He is slow to become angry. Okay? Slow. Just open hands and just kind of run it up. painted sign. You're going to start out like this, and you're going to end like this. And so you have to kind of time your finger movement so that you wind up with a trust. He can be trusted. He shows his faithful love for thousands of generations. He shows his faithful love. He, you know, shows. I'm showing you right here, right here, right here it is, right? Okay, show. That's where that tongue comes from. Shows his faithful. Faith is two F hands. One of them stays still, the other one comes down. Faith, full. You pull towards yourself. So, full and pull rhyme, if they can remember how to do that. Faithful. So faithful. Make that look like one sign, right? Faithful. love. For thousands of generations, thousands. You kind of hit your tip of your fingers in the palm of your hand. Thousands of generations. This is one generation, then it's the next generation, and that's where that sign comes from. Okay? So he is merciful, he is kind, he's slow to anger, he's full of great love, he can be trusted, and his faithful shows his faithful love for thousands of generations. Now comes the part where I think the translators have completely missed the boat. Okay? He forgives thousands of generations. And the actual text says, but remembers the guilt of the guilty and punishes them to the third and fourth generation. Okay? The translators here decided to take third and fourth generation and actually make it kids and grandkids and great-grandkids, okay? That's not the point. The point is God is comparing thousands of generations of faithful love to three, maybe four, generations of punishment. It's the disparity, it's the greatness of distance that makes it is what the point really is, but we're going to sign it like it is here. Can you tell I'm a little bit groused about it? The Lord forgives people for the wrong things they do. Okay? The Lord forgives. Here's all your debt. God forgives people. And if P is popping up and down, people. Four, point to the head, and then kind of circle your wrist a little bit. Four, the wrong things. And things is up closer to you. Things they do. It's kind of almost the same sign. Things and they. Word your things a little bit closer. They do. Alright? This is a sign for do, did, does, done, anything to do with that do type word. Do, 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 do. Okay? But he does not forget. I have it on my brain. I wiped it off. I have forgotten it. He does not forget to punish. Can you hear me hitting the bone on my elbow there? You don't have to hit it that hard that you can hear it. That's kind of what I'm doing there, alright? Softly hit the bone on your elbow. Punish. The guilty people. Guilty. This is like my heart going, ooh, I'm feeling guilty. Hit the G. Alright? He does not forget to punish the guilty people. He will punish not only the guilty people, I don't like to try to go there to punish, but it's like the train crossing, okay, but also, I mean the same here and the same here, also, losing my voice, their children. signs there. Children. He's like patting them on the head. Grandchildren. This is grandchildren. And their great-grandchildren. Grand, great-grandchildren. Okay? Will suffer. And it's just an A thumb kind of starting below the lip and coming down to your into your chin there. Suffer for the bad. I haven't actually described that. You know, your chin and then kind of like you're slapping hand. Bad. Okay? Things these people do. I think all of those signs have gone through. Then Moses quickly bowed to the ground and worshiped the Lord. Then Moses quickly bowed to the ground and worshiped the Lord. Okay? Then Moses quickly, like, you ever flip the coin? Kind of, you know, flipping the coin? It's that same flipping motion with two hands at the same time. It's quickly. Okay? Moses quickly bowed his head to the ground. Bowed his head to the ground. Means he fell on his knees and worshipped the Lord. Worship, make a fist, cover it with your hand, and do all these little things. Worship the Lord. Moses said, Lord, if, with the little finger pointing to your cheekbone, if you are pleased, say R, the same thing as B, only it's the letter R. Please, two P hands kind of circling, with me, now here with is not moving anywhere, so it's just plain old with me. Please go with us. Okay? Please go with us. Go. This is going, this is coming. We're rolling away from you to go, roll toward you to come. Go with us. I know, and I showed you know before in a different context, about bananas or something. No, these are stubborn people. These are stubborn people. Stubborn. Stubborn. This is also a sign for mule. It's that, you know, if you try to get a mule to go somewhere, they lay their ears flat. That's where that comes from. Stubborn people. But forgive us for the bad things we did. We know all those signs. Accept us as your people. Okay, accept. You have it here on a tray. I'm going to take it from the tray and I'm going to bring it to me. Accept us as your people. Then the Lord said, I am making this agreement with all your people. Okay? I am, we know those, making, we know, this, we know, agreement. This is time for agree. This is, I agree with you. Now what this is about. And it's not really an agreement. The right word here is covenant. Okay? So I'm actually going to sign it as covenant. It's the same kind of sign, only you do it with C's. Covenant. With all, kind of twiddle your hands there, all of your people. Okay? That's the vocabulary. Now go through this vocabulary and get it down good. Alright? The next video I'm going to do is the one where I do it with the recording there at LTC. And you'll practice with that. Okay? A lot of vocabulary here. Go through the vocabulary, get to where you're good at it. And I can't. stress this enough. Do it in phrases. Do it in sentences. Okay? Don't memorize the words. Memorize the sentences. How you want to sign the sentences. Because we speak in sentences. We really don't speak in words. Okay? It will smooth out your signs. It will help you to concentrate. It will help you to keep up. It will help you all the way around. Okay? That's enough. Started preaching, ended preaching. Two different subjects, though. Anyway, good luck.